everyone. I'm Daniela and I am the SolidWorks and SolidWorks PDM SME for SBK and Associates. Today I wanted to cover an error message that I've seen very frequently in a two-part series. So I wanted to go a little bit deeper into troubleshooting no database is connected to this view. Now I have covered this in a different video, so if you are in a crunch, you're looking for that solution, please hop over. This is likely an issue with the registry. But with that being said, this video is a little bit more geared to my PDM admins out there. When we see this error message or similar error messages, we tend to zero in on the things that we know are tried and true. Usually for me, this means there's something wrong in the registry. I know which keys I need to pull up and verify and how to fix it. Usually exporting keys from a working vault, importing, you're done. However, I did want to slow down and go through a more holistic approach to troubleshooting this error message. And this could be helpful for a plethora of other error messages, including other database error messages that you might encounter. So first, I would start off very simply, open up the admin tool and make sure that your user has the correct PDM version installed. So typically you will get a error message along the lines of this file and program are incompatible versions, something that will trigger you to check that out. But in my experience, I haven't gotten that message sometimes. So I will do a deep dive. I'll be in the trenches with error logs, trying to figure out what's wrong when it's actually a very straightforward solution. So in case this happens to you, it's a very quick check. You'll want to open up the admin tool and verify that their version is correct. For PDM admin, you only need to have the major version be the same. So you don't need to be on the same service pack in order to have a functioning vault. Secondly, is VPN. If your user is working remotely, you'll want to make sure they're connected to VPN and also gateways. This is something that has popped up for me as well. Some gateways may restrict certain ports, so you'll want to make sure that you play around with those gateways if need be. So ruling that off, if they are on the correct PDM version, if they are connected to VPN and you don't have multiple gateways, or they're connected to the same gateway you are, then we can proceed to the next step, and that is verifying that they can talk to the server. So typically this can be done via ping or telnet if you want to check on the port. So I'm dragging this over here. You'll want to open up command prompt and you can do a ping to the server. Typically you'll get four lines back. This will tell you your ping speed, it will tell you packet loss. So if you see a packet loss percentage, 100%, anything that is not zero, I would talk to your IT department. And this is the command you'll want to enter here. So ping and insert your server name here. Now, if you're a PDM admin, you know your server information very well. You know which one is your archive and which one is your database if they are separate. If you do not, please contact your PDM admin. Similar for telnet. So you'll want to enter telnet, your server and the port here at 3030. If your computer does not have telnet enabled, you will have to do that. It's a very quick step, but you'll be able to check if the port is open. This is another one that I've seen prop up with IT. IT will sometimes close off certain ports. So that's a great check to complete there. And now wanted to go over this as well. A successful telnet will look like this. Whereas if you receive any text, usually that means your telnet was not successful and there are port issues. So that narrows things down. You can reach out to your IT department and get them to take a look. In step two or part two, I will be covering what goes on from here. If these all check out, what else do I do? Please stay tuned.